morning all of you. I hope you all are doing well at your place. So let's start with our new chapter, chapter number 7, environmental changes, as we have completed till chapter number 6 in SS. So we'll see what is the environmental changes. Environmental changes occurs due to the change in due to the interference of the human and ecologically progress. Interference of human means interference जो है human का बढ़ जाता है as they do the different activities. And ecological progress means what? As we have many factories running for making the products, vehicles running on the road, so from that whatever smokes come, it affects the atmosphere. According to that, many changes occurs in environment change, and the environment change due to that. As the air that envelops the earth from all the sides, अब जैसे earth को air मिलती है from all the sides, so it's called atmosphere. So atmosphere is getting polluted by human activities. So the environment pollute due to the industries, factories, power stations and vehicles. As I said before in the definition, due to some activities like industries, factories, power stations and vehicles, the smoke which comes out from this, so it's affect the environment. So the changes that occur in temperature, the changes which occurs in the temperature, direction of the wind ka jo direction hai, that change, moisture, the humidity increases, etc., and the global warming are known as environmental changes. For as all things are increases, these are called the human activities, human interference in environment. So because of that, global warming also increases, and as they are increasing, obviously environment will be changed, it will not stable. So we'll see now what is weather. So the condition of a temperature, rain, moisture, humidity or any other things like whirlwinds, storm, etc. in any region at a particular point of time is known as weather. Means all these things, if they stay in any of the region for a particular time, is called weather. Jaise hum batate hain ki now weather is not good, it's like too humidity is there, it's too sticky, like that we are telling to the friends or anyone. So that is called weather. And you have seen the other, another name of weather is forecast. You will come to know what is the weather. So have you seen in the newspaper also, weather comes ki kya temperature chal raha hai, what is the temperature of today's, yesterday's, all come in the newspaper, even mobile also it's shown. So it's forecast the weather, wo weather ke bare mein hame batate hain. And one activity is there, if you can see in the textbook, so one map is there and two maps are there of climate, which shows us which climate is there. So if you see where it's sunny, sun is given, so that is called sunny summer season, that we can say that sunny temperature is there, means that climate is there. And the another is jahan pe it's too dark, so it's a rainy season. Okay, now our topic is greenhouses farming. Now what is greenhouses farming? Greenhouses farming means if vegetation is not grow properly, so we are doing arrangements so that the vegetation get the heat properly from the sun. Countries with a cold climate receives less heat from the sun, and this hampers the growth of the plants and vegetables. It means the countries which have the cold climate, they didn't get the heat properly from the sun. So somewhere it hampers, means it faces a problem in the growth of the plants and vegetation. So some arrangements they made that so that vegetation should grow properly, and the arrangements are made accumulate educate heat from the sun. The roof is made either for the glass or from the clothes to allow the sun rays to penetrate, means to allow the sun rays to come inside and to give the proper heat to the plant and vegetation so that it grows properly. and it shows as a building. You are aware that vegetation always grows in a open land, but as we have to do arrangement ताकि heat उन पे अच्छे से पड़े, तो we are making as a building. Roof बनाया जाता है, it is of either glass or cloth, as I have told you. So that is known as greenhouse farming. Now changing of climate. As I have told you priorly, environment changes due to the interference of human activity. As the environment changes, climate and weather also change. So have you many of times you have observed climate changes every time. Sometimes it becomes dry, sometimes sticky, humid is more, sometimes flood comes, rainy season comes suddenly. So these changes happen due to the environment changes. Now our topic is global warming. Now global warming refers to an unequal and continual rise in the average temperature of Earth's climate system due to greenhouse gases. Now due to the greenhouse gases, the temperature which is unequal and continuously rise the average temperature of Earth means the temperature which remains unequal every time, and the whatever temperature is there, it rise the temperature, so global warming occurs. Now I will let you know how the greenhouse gases occurs, कैसे ग्रीन हाउस गैसेस हमारे ग्लोबल वार्मिंग को डिस्टर्ब कर देती है. सो इट अकर्स व्हेन सर्टेन गैसेस इन द एटमॉस्फेयर एंटर इंफ्रारेड रेडिएशन. इट मींस व्हेन द डिफरेंट गैसेस एंटर, इट गेट मिक्स्ड एंड द रेडिएशन आल्सो गेट द मिक्स व्हिच इज अफेक्ट फॉर द अर्थ व्हिच इज सो थ्रू दैट द प्लैनेट द वेयर वी लिव इट गेट्स मोर वार्म, ज्यादा से ज्यादा गर्म हो जाता है. And with that we feel hot, and due to that global warming increase. Now we'll see the diagram which is given in the textbook. I'll explain you the diagram. As you can see, this sun is there. It absorbs the rays on the earth, absorb the atmosphere and the earth. This is the fire, deforestation occurs, smokes come. Jaise deforestation hota jata means forest destroy hota jata hai. That also problem occurs because rain नहीं हो पाती है ज़्यादा. So this is the power station, smoke निकल रहा है काफ़ी. The vehicles, oils and petrol engines, इनका भी smoke निकलता है. And as you can see, the smoke comes from here. यहाँ से plants cut किए हैं. From here earth lights come, sun rays come. This is the CFCs means the फ्लोरोकार्बन कार्बन. सो यहाँ से जो गैस निकलती है, स्प्रे में से जो गैस निकलती है, दैट ऑल गैसेस मिक्स टुगेदर. यहाँ से रेडिएशन फॉर्म होता है विच एब्जॉर्ब बाय द एटमोसफियर. सो ऑल द गैसेस व्हेन एंट्रैप, सो इट्स इफेक्ट द प्लैनेट एंड द प्लैनेट गेट मोर एंड मोर वार्मर जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट ग्लोबल वार्मिंग इंक्रीजेस एंड इट अकर्स. सो all of you understood this diagram, just go through once again so it will be clear to you. Our next topic is how does the earth get heated. Ab earth zyada se zyada kaise garam ho jati hai, how it gets more warmer and how it get heated. First before starting this I want to give the example. As I explain you the greenhouse, jaise greenhouse effect hota hai, like as all the gases mixed in the atmosphere, so it affects warmer, right? So if you cover yourself with blanket for 10 minutes, so what you will feel, so just do the activity, so you will come to know how greenhouse effect and how effect occurs in the planet. So result you will come to know if you will cover yourself in the blanket for 10 minutes. You the same we feel when the all the gases entrapped in the atmosphere. So we'll see, due to the greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbon, if all these gases increases, inki proportion jo hai, if it increase in the atmosphere, then obviously the earth leads the problem of global warming. So
if we'll see this diagram, this shows us that it is the increase of temperature by 0.6 degree Celsius from last 100 years. 64% of carbon dioxide, methane is of 10% and chlorofluorocarbon is of 65%, which we call CFC, and halocarbon of 0.5%. If all these get mixed on the earth in the atmosphere, so obviously planet will become more warmer and the earth gets more heat. That's why we feel that there is a much warmer season is there in India. So we'll see now what is ppm, part per million. If 280 ppm is there, it means 0.8% of gas increase in the earth. If you are aware that each person in the world release 4.5 metric tons of carbon dioxide, itne person jo hai, means one person, it release 4.5 metric ton of carbon dioxide. So we'll see the graph which shows the average temperature of the earth from last 150 years. I'll explain you this in the live session. And the next things will be effects of global warming. That we'll see in the next video, how effects comes when the global warming increases. Till that time, watch this video properly. Go through with the textbook. Whatever the graphs are there and related to graphs of information is there, I'll explain you in the live session. Till that time, take care of yourself and have a nice day. Thank you.